Hi, welcome to your practice. My name's Sophie and I'll be guiding you today through your yoga practice. We're going to be doing a deep stretch flow, a very juicy, stretchy, yummy flow today. It's going to be more at the intermediate to advanced level, and I only say that because I'm not going to be giving a whole lot of modifications for the poses, assuming that you know how to modify for your own body. So in the sense of cueing, that's why I say it's at that level, but of course anybody can do this practice and make the most out of it. We're going to get started in a seated position, and you can sit just like I'm seated here in Virasana, or you can sit cross-legged, and we're just going to sit like this to ground ourselves. Come to the back of your mat. Take a full breath in through the nose. Feel the breath go all the way up to midbrain, and breathe all the way down and out. Softening and releasing any tension. Inhale to fill up. Exhale to let go. Inhale. And exhale. Feel how your shoulders drop down and let your breath return to a natural rhythm in and out of the nose. Check in with yourself today. Check in with your energy, emotionally and physically. And just ask yourself, how am I doing? And then bring your awareness back to your breath again, in and out of the nose. Lengthen the spine a little bit more. Crown of the head reaches up. And then bring your hands down to the ground and slowly crawl your hands forward gently, softly like a cat into table. Extend your right leg straight back behind you and press back through your heel so you can stretch the calf muscles. Spread the fingers. Now take your right leg out to the right. And then sweep your left arm underneath your right arm over to the right. So you're in thread the needle, but your right leg is still extended. And if you want, you can reach your right arm forward. Let your left side of your head rest to the earth. Take one more full breath. Place your right hand down, come back onto your hands. Sit back on your left heel, but keep your right toes down on the ground. So I'll show this the other direction. Keep your right toes on the ground if you can, and if not, you can let the toes come up. And walk your hands down and fold. If you can, let your forehead rest to the earth. And use the breath to smooth out the mind. And then come back up onto your hands. Shift forward. Bring your knees back together. Extend your left leg straight back behind you and keep the toes down. Press back so that the heel really presses back. You get a stretch in the calves, and make sure you're not sinking into your shoulders. The shoulders are nice and stable, and you're pressing your hands into the earth. And then bring your left leg all the way out to the left. Set the bottom of the foot down. And sweep your right arm underneath the left arm. Set your right shoulder down. Crawl your left fingertips forward. Such a yummy twist for the upper back. I love any thread the needle. Let the weight of your head rest down into the earth. Set your left hand down. Come back onto your hands. sit back onto your right heel. If you can, you keep the left toes down and walk your hands forward and fold. Rise back up and forward and set your left knee down next to your right knee and walk your hands forward for puppy pose. So set the forehead down and see if you can stay on your fingertips. Just see how that, what that does for you. Two more deep breaths. Come back up onto your hands, tuck your toes, walk your hands to the back towards your knees, and sit back on your heels for toes pose. Bring your chin down to your chest. We're going to stretch the neck while we stretch our toes at the same time. So drop your right ear towards your right shoulder, but your chin is still a little bit down. You're stretching into the trapezius muscle on the right side, or on the left side, actually. And bring your chin back down to your chest and tilt your head to the left. Stretching into the right side of the trapezius muscle. Just observe the difference between the sides. No judgment, just seeing how that's interesting. When something hurts or something is weird in the body, just say, that's interesting. Bring your chin back down to your chest. Bring your head up. Come back down onto the hands. Untuck your toes. Take your right leg straight back behind you so that you're coming into a side plank facing the right side of the room. A modified side plank, rather. So your right leg goes straight back and your left knee is on the ground. Then reach your right arm over your ear to create a rainbow arc. Over your ear and maybe like the fingertips face down towards the ground. Like really creating a true arc as you press into the outer edge of your right foot. Move your left shoulder down and away from your ear. And then bring your hand down to the ground, come back into table. And we'll do the other side. Left leg straight back, modified side plank facing the left side of the room, left arm over your ear. Notice if you're holding any tension in your neck or in your forehead. Soften. For now, just soften. Take one more breath. And bring your everything back down into table and lift your hips for down dog. Pedal out your heels. Walk your hands to the back of the mat and come into a squat, come into malasana. Then bring your right hand behind your low back or maybe more towards the side, the hip, and bring the right elbow inside of your knee. So you'll see how the hand will probably might have to slide up a little just to get there. And then the other arm, the left arm, is just going to rest over the left knee. And just sit tall. And you might explore like some different angles on your own here. Subtle movements to feel. And then slowly release your right hand. Your left arm is going to go behind you. Make that chicken wing. And elbow in front of knee, and then your opposite arm on top. Feel around. And while you're doing this, you're reconnecting with your breath. Always re-reminding ourselves throughout the practice. Oh yeah, there's the breath. And then release, both arms out. Okay, now we're gonna do both hands behind. We won't stay that long. Elbows in front and just long spine. For 3, 2, 1, release your hands. We'll come to a fold. Forward fold at the back of the mat. Walk your hands all the way out to plank. Lower your knees to the ground and lower your whole body to the ground and lift up for cobra. downward facing dog. Hips up and back.
Lift your right leg to the sky. Lift it a little higher. And then step your foot outside of your right hand to lizard.
Put your back knee down, untuck the toes, and push your right hand into your right thigh as you push the right thigh away from you. And bring your hands down to the ground. Slide your right foot between your hands. Tuck your toes, lift your back knee. Walk your hands forward and come into kind of it's a supported warrior three is what I like to call it. So you're not in standing splits, your spine is still tall, and your fingertips are just touching the ground. So we use this moment with the hands on the ground to even out the hips, draw the right hip back, and really reach the crown of your head forward just to refine the alignment. And then take your arms into airplane if you can. And bring your left hand to the ground, bend your left knee and grab onto the foot. And now you can fold more into a standing splits as you point the left knee to the sky. Head drops down. Now you'll release the foot, but sit all the way down. So get really low and sit all the way down, sitting up for Ardha Matsyendrasana, half Lord of the Fishes. So sit tall, press down into the bottom of the right foot. Right fingertips come behind you and left arm hooks around. And if you're feeling spicy and want to bind, you can go for that bind. Left arm goes through, right hand goes around. One more breath. And then release your hands. And we'll come back to standing split. So walk your hands out in front of you and just lift your left leg up to the sky. Step your left foot all the way back to low lunge. Put your back knee down on the ground. Reach your arms up to the sky. Grab onto your elbows and take a back bend. Now release your hands back down to the ground. Lift your back knee and step back to down dog. Lift your left leg high. Step your foot outside of your left hand for lizard. Set your back knee down, untuck your toes. Push your left hand into the inner left thigh, push it away from you. As you move your chest back into a little back bend, anchor down into the top of your right foot. Just creating space in that left hip. And then put the left hand down. Slide your left foot between your hands. Tuck your toes, lift your back knee, and then walk your hands forward, come into supported warrior three. Reach that right leg back. Pin the left hip back. Really refining the pose. And when you're ready, extend your arms back into airplane arms. Knit the ribs in and up. Then put your right hand down, bend your right knee and grab onto the foot with the left hand and fold over your left knee as you point your right knee up to the sky. Release your foot, but keep your right knee bent and slowly lower all the way down, setting up for Ardha Matsyendrasana. Plant the left foot down, hook your right elbow over, left fingertips behind you, so you're twisting to your left. And then option for that bind. And maybe you can do it on one side and not the other, that's okay. Every time you inhale, you lengthen a bit. Every time you exhale, you twist a bit more. Release the hands. Come back to center. Walk your hands out in front of you and come into standing splits. Step your right leg all the way back to low lunge. Put your right knee down. Reach your arms up. Grab onto your elbows. Back bend. Release your hands down and step back to down dog. Lift your heels really high, inhale. Exhale, lower the heels down. Again, inhale, lift. And exhale, lower. Good, reach your right leg up. Bring your right knee to right wrist for pigeon. Set your leg down, slide your back leg back. Take a breath in. And as you exhale, walk your hands down and fold over your right leg. Let your forehead settle into the earth. Option to sweep the left arm underneath of the right arm into thread the needle, and then you can bring your palms together, kind of like you're in a little prayer twist. And then bring your hands back down and rise on up. Plant your hands. Step back to three-legged dog. Your right leg goes up and back. Now bring your right knee to your left upper arm. Cross it over. Extend your leg out over to the side. And then sit all the way down. So you're in a wide-legged position facing like the back corner of your mat, kind of. And then take your legs as wide as possible, sit tall, and walk your hands down and fold. Rise back up. Bend your right knee, so you're putting your right foot inside of your left thigh, setting up for Janu Sirsasana. And then face your left leg, torso faces your left leg, and fold over your left leg, forehead to knee. Take one more full breath. Rise back up. Extend your right leg straight back out again, so you're in the original wide-legged position. Then plant your right hand behind you. Lift your left arm up and lift back up into a rock star pose, the way we came in. Put your left hand down, sweep your leg up to three-legged dog, and then set your foot down on the ground. Lift your left leg up to the sky. Left knee to left wrist, pigeon pose. Set your leg down, slide your right leg back. And then walk your hands down and fold. Either stay here or sweep your right arm under your left arm. Bring your hands together into prayer. One more breath. Come back up onto your hands. Plant your hands, tuck your toes, and lift your back knee. Then come into three-legged dog, nice and graceful. Then bring your left knee to your right upper arm and extend your leg out to the side. Take your right arm up and sit all the way down. Legs wide, walk your hands forward and fold again. Really flex the feet as you roll the thighs back. Stretch as far forward as you can with your spine long. And walk your hands back up. Bend your left knee, setting up for Janu Sirsasana. So you're facing the back of your mat now. Your torso faces over your right leg, and you fold over your right leg. Just let your body spill over that leg. Forehead towards your knee, your shin. Two more breaths.
Rise back up.
Plant down through, sorry, extend your left leg out wide first. Plant down through your left hand, lift your hips up. Right hand down, three-legged dog, take it up and back. And then downward facing dog. Breath in and out. Come forward into plank. Lower all the way down to the ground. And then take your left arm, we're doing a lot of thread the needle today. Thread it over to the right. Now bend your right knee and bring the right knee up. Your hands are together, pancaked together. Then open your right arm all the way out to the right. So basically you're in a supine twist, but we just came into it a little differently. See if you can twist a little more by scooting your left shoulder to the left and putting your right shoulder down towards the ground. Mine's not touching, yours doesn't have to. Left hand on top of right knee. Smooth out the mind. And then bring your right hand back to meet your left hand. Slide your right leg back and come back onto your belly. And then both hands on the ground. And then slide your right arm underneath the left arm. Slide your left knee up. Pancake your hands together. And roll open to the left side. Right hand on top of left knee. Sink into the twist. Anchor your left hip forward towards the front of the mat. See how that subtle shift changes the way you feel here, the sensation. Then bring your left arm back around, hands together. Slide your left leg back and come back down onto the belly. Take your forearms out in front of you for Sphinx. Then bend your right knee, reach your right arm around, grab the inside of the foot. Slide your left hand forward so your chest drops down a bit, and then lift everything up. Everything lifts. Kick your foot into your hand, reach your left foot back towards the back of the mat rather than up. For three, two, one, lower down. Come back onto your forearms. Bend your left knee, reach your left arm around for the inside of the foot. Reach your right arm forward and lift everything up. Kick the foot into the hand. For three, two, one, lower down, use your hands as a pillow, wiggle out your hips. And then rise back up into table. Turn to the side of your mat so that your knees will have padding as we go into frog pose. So you're gonna take your knees wide, flex your feet, take your legs as wide as you can as you put your forearms down. You might eventually put your whole chest down or your forehead down. And take about five more slow breaths. Just try to surrender. I know it can feel like a lot. Just be here, be present with everything that you're feeling. Then slowly come up onto your hands. And bring the legs in. Take your time. I know coming out of that can be quite interesting. Take your legs out in front of you. Flex your feet, slight bend of the knees, arms reach up, fold forward. Grab onto the outer edges of the feet, re-lengthen and fold again. Maybe do that a few more times, undulating the spine, helping you arrive. And then arrive, finally. Be here in this pose with every fiber of your being, fully immersed in this moment, in this shape. Slowly rise up. And we're going to make our way into our final meditation. So you can either cross your legs and sit. I highly recommend sitting on a block or a bolster pillow. Or you can lay down in Shavasana. Once you find your comfortable position, take a full breath in and release. And ask yourself again here, how am I doing? Breathe here with all of your cells, all trillions of cells within your body, breathing together in and out. There's no expectations. All you have to do right now is exist. Let those thoughts pass by like clouds in the sky, just floating on by. I'm not getting too involved in the story. Let's bring the palms together at the heart into prayer. And then bring your thumbs to your third eye between your eyebrows. And we'll bow in gratitude for this sacred healing practice. Thank you. I'm so glad that you were here and practiced with me today. I hope that you feel amazing as you move into your day or evening. If you enjoyed the class, hit that subscribe button if you're not already subscribed. Hit that like button and comment and let me know what you thought so that I can know that you're practicing with me. Okay, I will see you in the next class. Bye.